What is up, guys? My name is Slip of Plazboys, and we are back with Slime Rancher 2. So we took a little bit of a break, just a little couple, I think it was a week. I'm gonna say it was a week. And, yeah, not much has changed. You know, I took a nice little breather from this after recording 4 in a row. A little exhausting. So anyway, we're back to it, and, yeah, so I think, you know, we got this done. Not a lot has happened since. We haven't got any new discussions with anybody. So, I'm thinking the focus of this episode will be to get some of these upgrades. And then also, I guess, try to find some drones while we do so. I think it's just going to be kind of more relaxed. Oh, yes. I want the pulse wave. Now I can punch things with air. Fun. No, but in all sincerity, while we do that, I think... Oh my god, it looks so much cleaner in this game now. It needs so much energy, but it's so worth it. I absolutely love that ability, it's so funny to me. But, like I was saying, I think this is gonna be just a hangout video, because there's not a lot left to do, at least not right now, because, again, there's still things that need to be added, such as I need more energy. Such as the labyrinth, which actually might contain more slimes from the old game or even new slimes. So that'll be something to see in the future, but as of right now, we're just kind of, I guess, just go through and read, you know, take a look at things. So yeah, I'm kind of disheartened by the fact this is the end of, I think, the series, or not this episode, but I think we're coming up on the end. Because I don't think there's a lot left to do. I think it's pretty much... There's no one in here, but I do need this. This would be helpful. But I'm just heartened by the fact that we're basically at the end of what we can do for now. Like, other than just kind of play around and check things out in more depth, admire things, and decorate, there's not a lot left to do. So, I don't know. We'll see what happens, but, yeah, was there one in here? There was not. So, you know, I've been a little busy. Just kind of just getting stuff done for classes and all that. Had a fun morning because I had a nail in my tire. So I had to go to mechanic, or I'm not going to call them mechanic. I had to go to Town Fair Tire. I'm not going to call them. I mean, I guess they are mechanics, but it's not like the mechanic shop where if I get repairs done, I could. Oh, it doesn't push them as far as it used to. Interesting. But I had to go get that done, which was great. This is the day I get to sleep in typically on my schedule. So having to get up early for an appointment made at Town Fair Tire was not exactly on my to-do list. And to be frank with you, I was not happy to have to get up and go do that this morning. It also wasn't cheap because, you know, you can't... You do tires on twos, so the tread is like the same, you know, same width and length and all that. For those of you who wouldn't know, which is fair, honest to God. But yeah, so just overall, really fun way to start my day. Did that, just, now I'm just doing this, really. It's been a pretty relaxing day, so. Yeah, not too bad, just, yeah, I don't know, it sucks to we're where we are, and I'm super happy to be where we are. It's glad to see that we progressed, but at the same time, it's kind of sad to be like, oh, we're pseudo towards the end of it. Actually, let me check the map, you know, because the right key. So there's still 9 of these remaining, so we can go find those somewhere in the world. But I think that's what it's gonna be. It's just gonna be collecting resources and trying to find those trigger pods. But yeah, it's just kind of like we did that one. Oh, have we actually been over here? Oh, we've been here. I know. I just don't know if we ever walked this little connection. Oh, okay. Yeah, I know where this is. Yeah, it's just because I'm not. Now I don't know what it's like to do, because like, this was like a thing I'll dedicate time to. How did I miss this? What? Oh, I don't want to go down there just yet, I think. Maybe I do. I don't know. I think I've been there before. Pretty sure I've been over here before. But, yeah. Let's tap into this. Trees like this one can live for thousands of years. I used to think that compared to us, they must perceive time very slowly. But then I realized that was because I was putting people at the center of time. In reality, trees have been here long before us, so their perception of time is closer to truth. We are here for just a moment before moving on, and the trees remain. I wonder who else this tree will meet. I wonder if it will tell them about me. Well, who left the logs here? Who did this? Answer the question. I don't know. But, yeah. No, so it's funny. I've been playing TF2 again, and now that I'm in college, you know, you meet all types of people, and you do all types of things when you are in college. You know, I think that's what the more beneficial side of college is kind of like that social, learn how to be an adult, but not be on your own aspect of college. Because, you know, it really is. It's like a trial run of being an adult. You get to, like, make some mistakes. Not intense mistakes, but, like, stupid ones like, oh, you're late to your job. Like, you're not going to get fired or some shit. At least if it's on campus. If you get fired, if you're late, you might not get fired right away. Unless you keep doing it, then you might be deserving of it. But, yeah, other than that, it's been pretty much just... that's really what it is. It's just a trial run of being independent and being an adult. And I think that's a big takeaway, but back to my point. So, like, meet all types of people, and one of my roommates actually does DND. So we've been playing that. I've been in a campaign with him. It's the Curse of Strahd. So for those of you who do the modules that, you know, Wizards of the... Is it Wizards of the West Coast? I think that's what their company is called. I'm sorry if I'm wrong. I'm new to it, so if I got the information wrong, please don't get upset. It's an accident. I'm not super into it like some people are. I really do wish I was, because it's so cool. I really enjoy it. Like, I'm currently drawing up sketches for our campaign, and it's just been fun. But, you know, I was playing and I picked the Artificer, Warforged, and I realized how similar he is to kind of like Engineer, where he's not like Engineer from TF2. That's where this like whole conversation started, because he's not. Dang it! Oh no, not that. This. Is that all? Oh. I think that's all of them. Okay. Because he's not direct damage, like, because the Artificer doesn't do, like, good direct damage. You know, he does good spell damage. It does good, oh, Wild Honey, how did I miss that? It does good, spell damage. It does good range damage, but melee, it's kind of, like, inept at. Not kinda, it is inept at it. Like, I tried using the sickle, and I don't hurt people. We were fighting zombies. I didn't do any damage. It wasn't that great. My cannon did a lot of damage. My crossbow did a lot of damage. But on an opportunity attack, while I was trying to take out one of my allies, it did nothing. It was like poking a bear with a stick. A tiny stick. That meant nothing. So, yeah, that was a realization. And it just kind of was like, huh, this really is reminiscent of TF2 to some degree for me, where it's just like, you're not doing the damage. Your gun, well, again, he can do damage with his guns, but it's like, you're not physically adept, you're range adept, and your sentry, or cannon, Eldritch Cannon, is what does the damage. So, I just thought that was funny, like, that little parallel there, and it just kind of was like, it made me realize I really missed out on naming my character, because I couldn't name him Dale, like Dale Conninger from TF2, but I didn't. It's also because Warforged, because I made a Warforged Artificer, and their names tend to be more robotic or machinery-based, industrialized, I guess? I'm going to go with industrialized. It's supposed to be like an industrial type of name, so like Gage or something. But because of that, like, you know, I just thought it was a funny little coincidence. Now I'm kind of drawing all the Eldritch Cannons to have a sentry-esque look to it. So, like, it has, like, the tripod legs. It's, very... I don't know how to describe the sentries from Team Fortress 2. They're very... I don't know. They're complex, definitely, but complex isn't, like, the best way to describe it. For those who, like, haven't seen it, I might just put a picture up. I don't know. But yeah, it's just... It's very reminiscent of me, or for me, to, like, think about the Team Fortress 2 engineer and his sentry, and then look at my Artificer Warforge, who is the... Artillerist route. By the way, I really like that route. I think it gets... I don't know if it's the best one, because I'm definitely intrigued by both the... What is it? The Battlesmith and the Armorist. Or the Armorer. I'm sorry, not the Armorist. The Armorer. Because the Armorer basically... It feels like, it, from how it sounds, you basically can make yourself Iron Man by putting a much different infusion on different armor pieces, allowing you to do different things. So I think that's kind of like a... Because you get, like, armor, like, I think, and armor and physical damage increase. Which I'm like, that's pretty cool. Oh, there we go. There is a pod, just like we're looking for. See, I told you I had a good plan. Resource gathering and collecting these. What do we got? Azure mangrove tree. Yay. Oh, whoa. How did I not realize this? Whoa. I never noticed how big this is. That labyrinth really is huge. And that's the... Oh, man. That's like a good... Jeez. Okay. You ever, like, that's, like, the whole, what is it, megalophobia is a fear of, like, ginormous things. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's megalophobia. Yeah, because of the, yeah, megalodon, megalophobia, like, yeah, big. I think that's what megalodon is supposed to be, like, large shark, or, like, giant fish. I don't know what megalodon means specifically. But... I think it's something along those lines. It has to be, because it's one of those, like, prehistoric names. Because you got, like, the Adon at the end there, and Megalo. Yeah, because Megalomaniac, Megalo... I'm sorry, I took Latin, and I'm not saying, like, this is, like, a Latin thing. Like, oh, like, in Latin you're doing a lot of... You do parse words. You do, so it's not entirely wrong, in hindsight. But what I'm trying to say is, like... Taking Latin, you learn to look for the pieces in words that make words what they are. So you can figure out what the context is when translating, because it's not... It's an entirely... if you've taken, like, any, like, language classes, it's... Everything's conjugated in Latin. Everything's conjugated. Everything has a different ending. You know, there's... I forget how many... But there's a large number where it just keeps changing. So, like, everything's kind of got an order to it. Everything's conjugated for a reason. It's a very intense language to, like, learn. But it's really cool. I just wish I remembered more of it. But I guess that's college. But, yeah. So, anyway. Back to the... Yeah, the Eldritch Cannon. Talking about, like, the Eldritch Cannon. Yeah, I think... Yeah, I was talking about the armor... Wow, I really routed off because of this. Yeah, that really took me off trail. But, yeah, the armor, I think it's basically you just become Iron Man or Tony Stark. I think if you play D&D and I'm completely wrong and you've done the Artificer Warforged, please explain it to me. I'd love to learn more about it because, honest to God, I think after this campaign, I'm going to make another Warforged Artificer. I think that's the best Artificer class, by the way, because I might be wrong. I could be wrong, but... For me, it feels good. I'm enjoying it, so I'm gonna just make some more Warforged Artificers in my up and coming campaigns. If I have any more, I'd love to have more. Just because, like, I'm enjoying it. It's just a fun class, and I'm looking forward to maybe if in another campaign I might make the Battlesmith next, honestly. Just because I like the thought of, like, the companion, like, just because of the... Oh, what's it called? It's an iron... It's not an iron construct. It's an iron defender. because of the Iron Defender, I want to name my character Lug, or Nut. I'll name him, I shouldn't call him. I want to name him Nut, so then when I make the Defender, I can call him Lug. So it can be Lug Nut, or... Oh, God, I had a better name. I had a much better name. Oh, my God, it was a really good one. It was one of those combo ones where it was like, oh, you're both, like, one half of, like, the full name. Oh, I can get up there. All right, I'm gonna try to do that. Just got to keep... Hold it down. Boom. Done. Oh, God, that's gonna hurt. That's gonna bother me now. Because it was... Oh, what was it? It was something really clever. I thought it was really clever. It might not be clever because I thought of it, but I thought it was clever. Oh, that's gonna... You ever have that where it's like you had a really good idea and you didn't write it down and now you just forget about it? Yeah, I'm having that right now where I just... Oh... It was almost like Jack and Daxter, or Ratchet and Clank. It was something like that, but it wasn't exactly Ratchet and Clank because I didn't want to just rip off Ratchet and Clank. It was like that idea though. But yeah, I might try to do Battlesmith next, and then if not a Battlesmith, maybe the Armorer. The Alchemist looks cool too. I admit that. I don't know if I'd be as into doing the Alchemist as I don't know if I'd be as interested in doing an Alchemist as I am the Battlesmith or the Armorer. They just... I don't know what it is. There's a difference of interest there. It's something I have to look into. Because I do have, like... I do want to play more D&D. Like, I was talking to one of my other roommates about the Strahd campaign. I was trying to leave as little detail out, or as much detail as possible. So, in case... You know, I ever decided to run that exact campaign, as dark as it can be, and because I ever wanted to run it, he wouldn't know any information. But as I was telling him that, he was like, I really want to do this, like, it sounds so much fun. So I might look into trying to run a campaign. I feel like it also would be a lot to do as somebody who's new to D&D as well. But I also might enjoy being a dungeon master. I don't know. That's a lot. I still have a lot to learn. Like, I don't understand how spells work, for example. Like, you can replace spell slots, apparently, but... It's like, there's limitations based on who, like, what class you are. Like, if you're a sorcerer, you can just do it. You know, it's no question to ask. But if you're an artificer, like, can you? You know what I mean? It's... Or maybe that's just, like, a house rule my DM has. It could be. Which, if that is, that's kind of sick, because I have... two spells that I'm like not using at all and I regret getting. It's Alarm and Snare, and I was thinking, oh, we might get more use out of this. I have not had one chance to use it because Snare takes so long to set up for what it does, and I just haven't used it. Like, I thought I could use it in one situation, and then when I read the spell, I'm like, oh, it's not like I can just kind of set it or like use it to grab somebody. It has to be set and they have to not know I'm setting it. Oh wow, I got a lot of... Okay. So it's like, it's not great. An alarm, it's the same deal. Like, you haven't had a situation where you need an alarm. Worst part is, I'm saying this as I'm, like, now, and watch. Like, next, like, say I actually get rid of them, then we're gonna actually need them. It's like, can I at least, like, a trap so we can rest peacefully? And then I'm gonna be like, huh. I did. For a time. And then I thought, huh. I don't need this. This is a waste of my, you know, spell slots. Get rid of it. It's gonna happen. That'll absolutely be what happens. Oh boy. It's also funny. Our party is all ranged. We have not all ranged. It's more heavily ranged, I think. It's definitely more heavily ranged, but that's not the problem. One, we have no charisma. We're really poor prepared. We're not charismatic at all. We didn't plan our characters at all together, and I think it makes for beautiful chemistry, because now it's like, well, you have plus one charisma, so I guess you're the most charismatic one here. You have to do all the talking. then none of us have like any strength. It's all like intelligence, wisdom, dexterity, and constitution. That's really what our party is. It's just those specific items, and I'm like, oh geez, this so it's interesting chemistry. But going on that point, it was kind of like, oh, where was I going with that point? Oh geez, I got on that like a tangent there talking about it. Oh man, yeah, I don't remember where I was coming from there. That's gonna bother so many people. I'm sorry, I lost myself in that train of thought. Is there any resources to collect over here? Yeah, I don't remember. Oh, that was not funny. Okay. Almost died there. Thought I was gonna die there. I didn't, so we'll take that. We'll take that win. Yeah, I really can't remember what I was saying there. I got so lost in talking about how our characters like don't have like any good stats for like, some things. Oh, right, I was talking about how none of our characters have direct spell attacks. Like, we have, I think, 2 direct attack spells out of the entire party. I mean, one of us isn't, like, a magic caster. He's a fighter. Or, no, he's a ranger. That's a class, right? I think it's a class. I'm not positive now. I'm gonna be honest with you. But, none of us have, like, any direct attack spells. It's like Thunder Wave, Tasha's Caustic Brew. You know, it's very much random. Again, we didn't plan any of our stuff out together. And we all got together as a group, and I'm like, huh, we don't have certain things. Like, we have major holes in our party. Like, we can't, like, use a magic missile on one target. No. We have Thunder Wave. I don't need more of that, actually. We have Thunder Wave. But we don't have anything else. Or we do have other things. But you know what I mean. It's like, it's AoE stuff. Like, Ball of Fire. It's not Fireball. I know what Fireball is. I've heard the memes about Fireball. It's not Fireball. It's... Oh, Flame Sphere? Flaming Sphere. It's Flaming Sphere. That's what it is. Yes. Flaming Sphere. One of us has Flaming Sphere. That's an AoE. Moonbeam. That's an AoE. It's not, we have no targeting spells. So it's just kind of interesting. That's right, because I was talking about why I want to change out possibly snare and alarm. Because, like, it was cool in my head. It was a cool idea in my head. It's like, oh, I can set a trap in an alarm system so, like, we can rest peacefully and I can snuck up on it. And then I realized that's not how this works. It might get used soon, but as of right now, it is not getting used. It's just kind of like taking up 2 spell slots where I could learn a possible direct attack spell and help my allies. You know, it's one of those. It's just one of those situations where I'm like, it was good in my head. It was a really enjoyable thought. I went the right way. It's a really enjoyable thought in my head, and then the execution just has not proven to be like effective. So in combat, I've only used shield and thunder wave for my attack spells or my like battle spells, because I have thunderclap and mending. My cannon got destroyed before I had to use mending, so I never got a chance to use that. I have to be able to upgrade something, right? I need 2 more deep run. I can get that here. I think primordial, it is primordial oil, really. Not primordial. Primordy. Interesting. This I can get, though. The dash boots, too. We can sprint even more efficiently, because that's how our body works. I guess we're cybernetic. We'd have to be cybernetic. Interesting. No, but, yeah, it's like, I don't have any direct attack spells, and it leads to interesting results. Oh. I'm not going to bother you guys with having to watch that. Let's just go hook that deep brine. And then we can get the energy upgrade. I think it's... I know there's deep brine I can collect here. Because we found that. That was like when we discovered, oh, stuff actually grows in the conservatory and we can collect it. I swear that there's deep brine in the... Am I wrong? Or am I just looking in the wrong spots? I'm looking in the wrong spots. Hold on. Not there. Was it over? I think this one had jellystone. I don't think it had any deep brine, though. Did it? No, it was jellystone. I'm pretty sure it was only jellystone. So we climb over to the other section for... Yeah, we can make it to the other section for... Oh, man. I'm not crazy. I swear there was deep brine somewhere in the conservatory. I'm almost positive. Really? I gotta make those portals. I could have sworn. But yeah, so all my spells have been AoE spells or shield. So it's Thunder Wave and Shield. Those are the spells I've used in combat so far. And it's like, again, they're not bad spells to use. I enjoy Thunder Wave. I really hurt some guys with Thunder Wave. Shield saved me in a very dire situation. If you play the Crystal Shard campaign or you've played it, you'll know what I'm talking about by dire situations. But, you know, those spells came in handy, but I haven't gone to use any others because, like, again, Snare, can't do anything with Snare unless you have time, set up time. Alarm, I can know if people are there. And that's it. I have Thunderclap, and Thunderclap's not that special because it's just a weaker version of Thunderwave. It's just a free Thunderwave for, like, if I wanted to just finish an enemy off and not do melee damage. And Mending, which I would have liked to use on my cannon, just didn't get the opportunity to. But it's fine. Alright, so now we have 250 health. We are officially the strongest health-wise for... Nope, Bastion has... Never mind. I'm not making that joke. It's kind of a dumb one. Oh, so there's still upgrades. There are still upgrades out there for... Is there? Yeah, because I think this... If it's all, like, blue, no black outline, it's completed. If there's a black outline, it means you can get it. You have to find the upgrade, though. So that's something to keep in mind. So we'll have to look for those. But yeah, so I have to figure out if, like, I can change spells out or not. I know it's been a huge tangent explaining something that's so simple as just, hey, can I change out my spells for this reason? I have to look into it more. Because if I can, then I'd like to be able to possibly change out my spells to have, like... Maybe not Magic Missile. I think that's a level 2. If that's a level 2, I'm taking Magic Missile. Because if that's a second level spell... That's a good second level spell. I know that's a big one because it never misses, it has good damage, and it can only be prevented by, I don't know how Magic Missile works. I think you can roll to reduce damage, but yeah, I don't know for sure. Yeah. But I think I'm going to call it there for this episode, guys. I hope you enjoyed just kind of me talking about D&D. I might talk about that more in the next... future episodes if you like that. So yeah, you can probably pwn me in the comments and, well, actually the way that this works, if you want to do that, feel free to. I don't actually judge on that shit because I didn't say that. It's fine. I don't actually judge on that stuff because, again, it's like every, you know, I'm interested in it, and all sincerity, I'm interested in it, so to learn things about it would be really cool. So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Bye-bye.